Hello everyone and welcome to the fourth episode of my devlog series about the development of a multi-platform simulation game, Lia. In this week's episode you will see how the camera movement works in 2D games with maps, also some smaller features that I just got done for my game, and one of the crucial moments in every simulation game, timed events. Some examples of such events are building time, daily rewards, producing goods, etc. First of all, I started the development this week with the simple feature, item tag. I wanted this to be displayed every time that I click on an object and if it is not a building. Next thing I started developing was camera movement. At first I managed to get the camera moving and zooming, but I immediately got a bug with UI elements that are supposed to follow the house. It turns out that these elements depend on the camera positioning. I fixed it by offsetting them by current position of the camera. My next problem was with objects in editing mode. When you enter it, camera script is disabled because the camera is supposed to follow this object automatically without player's input. I wrote a separate script that was activated exactly when the editing mode was on. It seemed like it worked fine, but when an object was in the center of the screen, the camera began to shake. Also, the trees were too small to make the camera follow them. As you can see, this approximately small feature took a lot of my time, but it was an important feature, so it was worth time spending. Even more, I want to return to this part later, because it is not as smooth as I wanted it to be. I actually solved my problems by making edge area when the camera has to start moving dependent on an object's size. The shake was caused by a simple mistake in an if statement, caused by copy-pasting it multiple times. As you can see now, my camera works well, and for now it is enough. Next, I started designing house information window. It will be used to view who lives in a house. At first, I was going for round portrait frames, but it looked too crowded, so I switched to rectangular placeholders. I made floral frames to them, from the same assets that I used earlier. Looking at them now made me think if I should make this less flowery, because it is a magical game, not flowery. I would want to see something like mushrooms and moss on this board rather than flowers. Let me know in the comments what you think about it. Then I started working on the functionality of this window, and I added animation, which is basically just sliding upward and downward, implemented in a coroutine. The next thing that had to be done was window initialization. After all, it was designed to show the members of a house. I created a scriptable object of a person that will contain the necessary information to fill in this window. The mechanism is similar to what I used with shop items. You can watch it in one of the previous episodes of Lia Devlog. A little reminder to avoid using hard-coded values in your code. It can cause you unexpected behavior like this one with my window. As more text started appearing in my game, I had to go look for a significant font for my game. I found this website with top 40 free fonts for personal and commercial use, but I didn't choose the right one there. Instead, this website led me to another one that had a lot more choices. So this is what I ended up with. And finally, the most useful part of this video, time-based events, or as I would refer to it in this video, building time. Not to confuse with application building time. I will be talking about house building time. Considering that I didn't find a good tutorial on this topic and had to figure out the process on my own, I will make a brief description how I implemented this in my game, but if you want a full tutorial, like this video and comment below. At first, I only made a button to test the script that I found online that was getting real-time and date from server in order to prevent players from cheating. Then I added a few fields to my object data class that was used by the saving system. String that contained building start time and date, and also building finish time and date. I calculated the ending time based on a house prefab property that I added. I made an enum for building status, not built, in progress, and built. When an object is placed on the map, it runs a method to start building. If an object is initialized as already built, it will simply make a return call. If it is not built or in progress, it will start a coroutine for building. When this coroutine finishes, it can fire an event that you want. For me, it is just an opacity change to show that the house is now available. It was supposed to work, but of course, at first it wasn't. I figured out that connection to server was too time consuming, so for test, I'm just getting UTC now time and using it. However, it didn't change the fact that houses in progress were not saved from game to game. I fixed it when I realized where I wasn't assigning values properly. I added a method to display a tag when the building is not finished, and also a countdown to the moment it will be finished. Usually, you would see a progress bar on top of the building object, but I don't want to take up too much screen space with UI, because I want the player to enjoy the view of the town. I tested house saving, and as you can see, it worked. After the building time passed, you return to the game and you can see that the house is built. This is how the game looks now. You can easily move around the map, zoom in and out. You can now move a building and the camera will follow it. When you actually place the building, you will get a timer running until the building is finished. The time left will be shown in a tag. If you click on a decor item, a similar tag will appear with name only. And if you were to click on a finished house, you will get a window that has all characters that live in this house. If you quit the game, the building progress will be saved and loaded when you come back. This is it for this video. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe to my channel to see weekly progress on this game. Bye!